Texas Podcast Massacre contains spoilers and adult language. For more horror, visit us at our website at texaspodcastmassacre.com.
Welcome to another episode of Texas Podcast Massacre, coming to you from Houston, Texas. I'm your host, Mitch, and with me, as always, is the Kayako to my Sadako, Nate. Nate, did you take the cough drops I gave you?
Oh, hey, sorry, guys.
I gave you some Ricola, and doesn't seem to be working.
Is that what she's saying the whole movie? Ricola.
Man, why? Look,
that was the first draft.
We all know. Well, we all know Japan has some great, like, crazy ass commercials. How is the Grudge? How was Kayako not doing like cough, like sore throat commercials?
That would be amazing. Yeah. Then you give her like a Halls cough drop, and she's like, "I'm all better."
Yeah, that's right. As like a Vicks, it was the whole thing was a Vicks ad. Like it was like in the credits. I didn't watch all the credits. Maybe it was paid by Vix.
Ooh, you missed something in the credits if you didn't watch all the way through.
Oh, my God.
But look, besides Nate, of course, we have our queen unsuspecting victim. I don't know. Which one of these do you more? Are you more of a Sadako or a Kayako?
I am more of a... I'd like to formally announce my retirement from Texas Podcast Massacre after having to watch this film. So thank you.
No, we
it's
can't.
Been a joy and a pleasure.
This was the one? This was the one.
This was it.
Oh,
this
man.
Was it.
Remember when like Muhammad Ali like boxed like three too many times and you just get pumbled by people? Like,
yeah, I feel
like
I've
you're
watched...
doing it too late. You're too late. Like you might as well...
hundreds.
The damage is
more
done. The damage is done. You might as well just see it all the way through to the bitter end. Yeah. So welcome to another episode of Texas Podcast Massacre, where each week we take a look at a different horror movie and debate a horror related topic with our unsuspecting victim, who is more often than not Lisa. Sometimes we drag some friends of ours along, some special guests. But Lisa, you can't retire. We have people request movies all the time with the subject line, "I'm so sorry, Lisa." I mean, people have your best interest at heart.
They
love you. They just want you to suffer with us. I mean, it's
have a tiny bit of sympathy for me.
They do. They like you so much. They want you to be part of our world. It's like you're like Ariel, you know. Wish you could be a part of this world. Come on with us. So this movie.
Come on, ride the train.
I don't know.
Do ride it.
That could have been real weird. I don't know where you were going.
Could have been. I believe I hit the mark on the weirdness.
I was waiting for a whole new world pivot there too.
Oh, man, we could have done a whole lot of that. Yeah. No. So look, this week's episode, look, we're finishing up our versus month. Nate, we've seen some pretty awesome fights, some pretty awesome battles.
Sure.
We've seen some really garbage plots and stories.
That's correct.
And yes. Mediocre at best acting.
Sure.
Now, this month was bookended by this movie, Sadako versus Kayako, Ring versus Grudge, you know. Yeah. And I have been trying to get y'all to watch this since we like started the podcast, and I knew Shudder had this. I found out this was actually at one of a very early Fantastic Fest. Nate, had we been going to Fantastic Fest all these years, we would have already seen this movie in its glory in the theaters.
I'm glad I waited. relative to Alien vs. Predator Requiem, this could have been the perfect time to watch it.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see. I'm curious what y'all thought. I've been very mum about my opinions of this movie. Outside that, I just wanted y'all to watch it. So I'm really excited. Excited to hear.
We both assume that you love this. Right, Lisa? I mean, I just assume that you love this massively.
Mitch, wait. Hold on. Nate, I got a question for you.
Okay, what's the question?
Over under on how many times Mitch has seen this movie?
Oh, over under. I'm gonna say.
Let's set the line at 5.
I'm gonna go under.
You're gonna go under?
I'm gonna go under. I hope.
No, that's a pretty high line for me, and I'll tell you because Nate knows.
Okay.
Nate knows that unless I really love a movie, I don't typically watch it more than once. I have to really like one. In fact, yeah. That's usually when I get out of a theater, I tell Nate, that's how Nate and you usually know that I love a movie. I'm like, I want to watch this again.
Okay, so yeah. How many times have you seen this?
I will set the line for you at 3.
That was where I was going to put the line
I'll
to make it interesting.
I'll take the line, though. I think you've seen it 3 times.
Okay, you'll take
the... I think you've seen it 3 times also.
You think I've seen it three times.
Oh, that's exactly goodness. What I was going to say, yeah.
Okay. Well, we will find out later. I don't want to tell y'all now. Let's build the suspense.
Hold on. Well, now they've gone into it. What movie have you seen the most ever?
So the most in theaters for sure, and probably still maybe the most I've seen ever, the original 1996 Mortal Kombat. I literally saw that in theaters every day for about a week and a half straight.
Oh, that is awesome.
Shout out to my mom who took me to it once and was like, if you want to go see this again, you can just go on your own. I'm not taking you back.
Like, you're 10.
Like the movie theater people there, like they knew, like my mom had taken me. So, and they knew me. So they were like, fine. Yes. Mom would buy the ticket and then literally just be like, have fun. but yeah, Mortal Kombat, Mortal Kombat just came out. In fact, look, why don't we move into our debate question for the week? Cause I got some stuff to talk about.
Bid our father, the Sea King, rise from the depths full foul in his fury. Black waves teeming with salt foam. To smother this young mouth with pungent slime.
Now, normally we have a debate question, but look, versus month, and we had a very highly anticipated fight movie drop, Mortal Kombat. Yeah. Now, Lisa, you have not watched Mortal Kombat yet.
Not the new one.
Have you watched any of them?
Yeah, of course I have. I'm with you.
Now, you didn't watch Annihilation, though, right?
Is that the one before this?
That may be the worst movie that's ever been
that was
put
the,
on film.
The sequel. I don't think so. 1996, you know, then you get the sequel, and it was...
I think I watched the original.
Trash. I wish I had 4 arms like Goro to throw it in the trash as fast as possible. That's how bad it was.
Yeah. Yeah, the sequel was, I mean, like the razziest of razzies, I feel like.
I hope that they make... one more at least, but this time I want to see all the friendships instead of the fatalities.
Oh yes. Yeah, Lisa, when we have played together, Lisa opts for the friendships over straight murdering
that's
anyone.
That's fair.
Surprise.
Now, Nate, I don't know if you recall, we actually had a Mortal Kombat tournament years ago at our old house, and I bring it up because I ran roughshod on all of you. Undefeated. I was basically Shao Kahn, just straight murdering all of y'all. Like, we had friends coming in from like off work to our house to join in because they were like working a little bit later and like jumping in trying to beat me. None of y'all could. Our friend Robert, we nicknamed him Captain. Long story and no one cares. But he was the only one closer to beat me. Nate, I can't remember if I played you though. Do you remember this at all?
I don't know if I played that or not. I don't remember this.
This may have been before we were hanging out. Oh, like as much as we do now, certainly. But
I'd be rated. That I know the rated moves. That's all. That's the only person I would possibly know.
Yeah, this was like the first remake, like the newest ones that come out. So
oh,
I think
the
like
new
not,
ones. Oh, I'd have no chance. Yeah, I'd have no chance.
Oh yeah, I was just straight murdering everyone. It was glorious. That's all I wanted to talk about. That was the debate question.
That's it. We did it.
No. So, Nate, instead of really kind of having a debate about this, because we can still debate, but I'm curious, overall thoughts about Mortal Kombat, the movie, the new one. What did you think?
I thought that it fit perfectly in with the Versus Month. The story was laughably terrible. And but the fighting was very good.
Yeah. Yeah, I want
and so, very brutal, very R, you know, they weren't messing around in this one. Like people's spines are getting shattered all over the place, necks broke. You know, there's some blood. They really leaned into the R rating on this one, which I enjoyed. That was nice to see.
Yeah, I've already watched this movie twice. That's so, as I said earlier, if I like a movie, I'm going to watch it multiple times. Number three is coming soon. I need trying to get Lisa to watch it. Lisa, what is your, now, are you excited to watch this movie? You seemed like you were potentially interested. That is a nope. All right. Well, it is fantastic.
Your eyes.
I am neither a fan of The Ring nor The Grudge. Why?
Well, neither of them are in the Mortal Kombat movie.
Oh, sorry. We're talking about the Mortal Kombat movie.
Yeah.
I think you guys were talking about Mortal Kombat.
You're
so
just
long,
so, you're already out. So like, okay. Very, so you're know. Already, you're,
I'm
you're
sub-zero guys. Over here. I'm like, can we just move on?
Sadako versus Kayako versus Mortal Kombat.
We're here to talk about one movie and one movie only, and that's not Mortal Kombat.
All right, fine. Well, look, we'll take real quick. If you haven't seen it, you absolutely should. It's on HBO Max. You can go see it in theaters. Nate and I actually went to the theater.
Yeah, we saw it in theater, baby.
Great, woo! Yeah. Yeah, it was one dude was living his best life.
Was amped up in the front and coughing very loudly.
Yeah, nothing like the first time you go to a theater.
Moving around like through the aisle and then going back down and sitting in a different seat to then also cough loud. I don't know.
There were people around us who were ready to have their own Mortal Kombat tournament with this guy. He didn't calm it down. So
the guy was like kind of tall. He looked like his hair was like Kramer from Seinfeld.
Yes.
This guy was got a whole deal. End of the movie. the way worse ending credits than the original one. He was just pumping his fist like, yeah, put his hand up like, yes.
Nate,
Mortal Kombat.
We stayed in that theater. Like we stayed in the parking lot chatting for a little bit. I don't ever remember seeing him ever actually leave the theater. Like we stayed for a little bit. He might still be like, in there like shadow boxing and just.
That guy's like pumped. Round two fight. Like, I'm just going to stay here. I'm not even going anywhere. I live here now.
So if anyone's wondering what theater experience post COVID's like, there you go.
It was something.
Definitely go see this. Definitely see this movie. It's, you know, I don't know. I know there's been a lot of mixed reviews. It's the action's
it
awesome.
It is mixed. It's mixed. It's a mixed movie.
Yeah.
When they're talking about anything, it's terrible.
It's just
when
a movie
fighting,
that.
It's great.
Yeah. It's just a movie that like clearly was written with the intent of having multiple movies. And look, it flat out just robbed a bank in terms of how much money it made. So sequels are coming.
I'll tell you this, out of all the Versus movies we've done, it is the most Versus of any of the movies. There's a lot of fighting, this movie does not have as much. So
that's true. All right. So look, real quick debate question. So Lisa, I mean, the reason why I've always been particularly big on this is I just like the Ring movies. I think the Ring is as near as a perfect horror movie as you can get. Besides,
which one? Hold on a second.
The American Ring.
Oh, interesting.
Okay. And I say that only because, you know, so often, first off, it inspired the entire J horror wave that came over. Not that a lot of them are great, but I think it helped introduce a lot of people to those types of movies. But also, I think, unlike most remakes where, you know, someone takes a movie that was really popular overseas and tries to either Americanize it or the reverse, right? So the director, Gore Verbinski, who went on to do the Pirates of the Caribbean franchise. So, you know, think what you will. But he did a really smart thing about tailoring the imagery and some of the story to American audiences. And so not just being like a straight shot-for-shot remake. I mean, and largely it is very, very similar. But he does some things that just work well. And we're just not used to that type of ghost. You know, that type of, you know, ghosts and spirit is very typical of Japanese, like, mythology and stuff. Not so much here. So it just plays a lot better, I think. And, I mean, it clearly was a huge franchise. I mean, hell, The video campaign for this movie in Japan had Sadako and Kayako throwing the first pitch at each other at a baseball game.
I'll get into
so it's clearly pop culture. I mean, she's certainly a pop culture icon. Even The Grudge probably to a degree as well. I mean, how many Grudge movies do we have in America now?
I'll get into it.
Almost gotten remade as much as Jason at this point.
Don't worry about it.
But now, Lisa, would you like to, your history with The Ring and The Grudge is not as much of a love affair as mine is.
I've already told this story in the podcast before. People don't care.
Mitch
tried to get me to watch The Ring way early on in our relationship. And then he was going to leave. We weren't living together. We weren't engaged. We were nothing. Just dating. And we watched like 5 minutes of it. And I said, no, thank you. No way. No, you're not making me watch this and then you're leaving and I'm alone in my apartment. You're crazy. I don't know how much longer after that. It was definitely after we were married, I think, that I finally watched it. I think. Like maybe during the middle of the day with the sun high in the sky. Mm-hmm. The Grudge, I don't even know when we watched it. I mean, it's creepy as all get out, but that one doesn't, I don't know why. The Ring just always sticks in my mind. The Grudge is really bad, but
The Grudge is it's just two different types of horror and scary. Like The Ring is just stays with you in terms of the imagery and the suspense and that piece. The Grudge is just like straight, like, scare the shit out of you horror. Like that's the creature horror versus
the Grudge is just ganking people. A lot of ganks.
I mean, there's that. I mean, that scene where Kayako is coming up through the bed sheets and like she's not there, and they lit the bed sheets. All of a sudden, she's just right fucking there. I jumped in the theater when I saw that initially. So
I would say we can get more into it when we actually talk about the movie, even though we're talking about the movie, but I don't know if I have a different perspective now on both. I actually kind of felt bad for both of them. Well, we'll get into it. We'll get into it. But
sure. Tragic backstories abound. So mine's a big question for y'all. It's just this.
tragic backstories.
Look, these ghosts don't exist without something terrible happening. Look, let me get into this.
The real backstory is how Kayako's back is totally messed up. That's the real backstory here. You see how she's contorting herself?
Well, let me ask you this. I mean, all the verses. If you had to pick one of the things from one of the movies we watched this month versus another one. So different movies. Can't be Alien versus Predator. Yeah. You have to pick. If you want Alien, it has to be some other thing. What's the next matchup? I mean, imagine this was a bracket. And we had definitive winners. Who do you want to see in the championship?
I would say mine, but then I'm going to spoil this movie. Okay, I'll just tell you guys.
That's how podcasts
I'm
going to
take the Alien Predator hybrid from Alien versus Predator.
I know where you're going. Okay. If you don't want to.
The Predamorph.
Versus another potential creature that came out of the ending of this movie.
So you're gonna the Sadakaya.
Yeah, just say it, Nate. Just spoil it after I tiptoed around it.
Sadako.
The Pred Alien.
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, that is interesting.
Yeah. That's probably the best answer, honestly.
Yep, done. Moving on. It's so nice to go out on my retirement episode.
Oh my god!
Wow, what a send off.
Because Godzilla's gonna beat everybody. Who is Godzilla? Like Godzilla and
that's
Jason.
That's what I was gonna say. Godzilla versus Sadako. One. Actually, this is the movie. Okay, so this is the movie. Sadako is just going crazy, right? Internet. Everyone's watching this video, just loving it, right? But you can't play videos if your entire house is crushed via Godzilla, right? Sadako has got to stop Godzilla from killing everybody before they watch the video. That's the movie.
Okay.
I actually think, so I would be interested to see Jason versus Kayako because they both have fairly similar backstories. I mean, the little boy is Kayako's son. He was drowned, just like mm-hmm. Jason was drowned. So you okay. have a mother-son, yeah. you have a mother-son duo against a dude with very clear mommy issues.
You don't think
issues.
They'd sympathize with each other?
I don't know.
I think they might join up.
It yeah. could be. That could be a good tag team for sure.
Yeah. But can't Kayako like not leave that house?
Apparently she can.
Well, who gives a shit? Jason. Yeah, Freddy will just go tell Jason. You know, it's like the Japanese version of the Elm Street. Freddy's going to tell Jason to go over there and make them remember. I don't know. There's probably some. Okay. That's in the Japanese remake of the movie.
As long as Kayako stays in the property line, it's totally fine. I don't know yeah. how long.
I wouldn't mind seeing Alien versus Godzilla. You know, having like the Queen coming back and fighting.
The Queen is like a 1/50th of the size of Godzilla.
Oh, okay. Sorry, Jason and who else did you say? Like Sadako? Yeah, because that she's monstrous.
Sadako versus Godzilla isn't a fight directly against each other. It's the fight for getting the humans before Godzilla kills them all. That's what the movie is.
Yeah, but with aliens, it's like a bunch of aliens. Like the numbers against the size.
Then Godzilla just like charges up his nuclear breath and then all the aliens are gone. Look, the aliens were getting outmatched by Colorado people in a sporting goods store. Pretty sure Godzilla can handle them. I'm not too worried about that one.
Well, there you go. Well, look, we want to know, who do you want to see? Who? What's the main event match y'all want out of this whole matchup? I think Lisa has the most ridiculous like possibilities in terms of what could happen.
Then you get four creatures in one.
That's true.
I actually like, do ghosts dream?
You want to do it?
Freddy versus Toshio, the kid with Kayako. He preys on kids. He's a ghost kid. Does he dream? And then Kayako's got to try to get Freddy. She's got a dream warrior for her kid. That would be sweet.
Actually, that one's pretty good.
Yeah.
I like that.
All right. There you go. Suck it, Mitch.
Good job. You came back strong, Nate.
There's that.
Hold on. If that's the last thing, Lisa, you could walk off right now. I give you permission. You're it. That's it. We did
no,
it.
Yes. No.
It's been a great 3.5 years.
You're gonna drop off on episode 199.
Is this episode 199?
It is episode 199. Oh, yes.
That's the perfect time to leave. That's 199 more movies than I ever should have had to watch.
You have 199 problems. This podcast is one. Yep.
So again, you can let us know at TexasPodcastMassacre@gmail.com. I guess send your well wishes to Lisa. DX Pod Massacre.
Give us a 5-star review and then pick a movie, but also say Lisa, hashtag Lisa don't go.
Yeah.
Just put that in there.
Yeah.
And also put Gretel versus Hansel for Mitch.
I swear to God, leave the podcast if Gretel and Hansel.
Would you rather watch Gretel versus Hansel? Or Gretel versus Hansel?
Oh my God.
That's another movie.
That's one I would actually be okay with.
Or Gretel and Hansel.
The witch is putting them. That'd be cool. The witch is putting them against each other, and the loser's going to get eaten. Ooh, I like
that. That sounds good. See, like it's possible. It's the Gretel.
Better than the other Gretel movie.
Gretel versus
Hansel. Sure.
I love it.
Okay, would I rather see what?
Gretel versus Hansel or Human Centipede? Which one?
Oh God!
Oh my gosh!
All right, look. With that said, let's get into this week's movie of the week: Sadako versus Kayako.
サダコという幽霊から電話がかかってきて、お前は2日後に死ぬと告げられる。見てみようか。あそこ入ったら呪われて死んじゃう家なの。あの家絶対近寄っちゃダメだよ。サダコ見たのか。ここにいるの。 呼ばれてる。
ちょっと。
私の呪いとあなたの呪いを見つける。私たちが生き残る道は。
What was that music? You know, so I knew that, like, no one's going to understand. They, you know, unless you speak Japanese, you're not going to understand what's being said in the trailer. But the tonal shift of that trailer with whatever. I mean, I don't even know what band that was. Some hair metal band. That was something else. Nothing like seeing Sadako crawl the TV while you're here and someone in the back going, no, 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 no. I just, man, banger soundtrack. So Lisa.
Nathan, total agreement. Yeah.
I, like, yeah. No, no, no. God, with that. Yeah. Lisa, what can you tell us about this movie? What is this movie about?
Lots of people wittingly or unwittingly get cursed. Mm-hmm. And then try to save themselves by pitting two curses against each other. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. With three of the most terrifying creatures I've ever seen. Mm. Definitely, the movie itself is completely not unsuspecting victim friendly. If you did not like The Ring, if you did not like Grudge, do not watch this. It is basically The Ring and The Grudge over and over and over again. Now, that being said, the cursed tape, completely and utterly unsuspecting victim friendly, and I'll tell you why. The second you turn that on, guess what? Now I'm going to open out. Just, psh, nope, mm-mm, done. Throw it away.
Oh yeah, look, hey, I found a really mangy looking videotape with no label in this VCR that I bought at a pawn shop.
That's why I'm all Blu-ray right here. See? Boom, got it covered.
Oh my God! So the Naterian collection doesn't have a curse video in there.
Naterian collection, no curses. So
yeah, it
far.
Does. I know. I see Ice Cream Man on the shelf right now. I know it does.
Mitch is trying to curse me over here. He pulled up his notes and it's got screenshots and it's just got Sadako's eye looking at me and I'm like, oh no, thank you.
What is happening?
Oh, I'm ready, Nate.
Yeah,
let's do this. What can you tell us about the classic film Sadako versus Kayako?
The classic.
I don't think a film made 5 years ago can be considered classic.
Well,
it's not even 5 years. But it's a classic in the versus genre. That is actually the versus genre is huge if you count all the Godzilla movies, which I've been watching all of them with my son. Oh my God, it's every movie is like a versus, like a four-person versus. So maybe that's next year, Mitch. It's all Godzilla movies.
Okay.
Sadako vs. Kayako came out June 18th, 2016 in Japan. It is a tight 98 minutes. It did not release in the US in theaters, but it went straight to Shudder, one of like the kind of OG Shudder exclusives, January of 2017, so right before, a little before the podcast started. It was in theaters in Japan, made about $8 million, so not that much in the theaters. There is a promotional thing where for the Nippon Ham Fighters and the Yakut Swallows played a game. And Sadako and Kayako and Toshio were all involved in the opening in the pitch.
Guess what, Nate? Guess how many times I've seen that, okay?
How many times you've seen that?
Mitch showed it to me a while back, and then we're about to watch this movie, and Mitch goes, oh, wait, I got to show you something on YouTube. And I was like, I don't need to see the opening pitch again. Thank you.
I wanted to give her like the Alamo experience. I have the little random clips playing before. No,
but did you see their collaboration with the Hello Kitty brand?
No.
For this movie? that you might be interested. Just look it up.
Joking.
They also created an Instagram that had Kayako and Toshio just like lazing about, having a normal fun time around the house.
All right, you're gonna have to text us this. Hello Kitty thing.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Oh my God! Yeah. No, we found it. That's amazing.
So there you go. I figured you would like that. I figured that would be. That would be all.
Wow! Look at that.
I'm bored with that.
Look at that.
That's something.
That's
else.
Something.
Yep. So anyway, Hello Kitty. This is for the kid. This is a kid. This is for the kids for sure. There's a kid in the movie. It's great.
There's a kid. Ooh, and that's a perfect crossover. It should have been Hello Kitty and the kid because he talks like a cat. So,
Hello Killy, and then. Terrible. All right, Mitch, this is quiz time for you.
Okay.
First question is, how many U.S. versions of The Grudge have there been? Do you know off the top of your head?
U.S. version, there's the original one with Sarah Michelle Gellar. There's the most recent remake. Are we counting sequels or just like the original?
And sequels. How many U.S. movies?
I'm going to... I think four.
There has been four, correct. Yes. How many Japanese movies been on the Ju-on?
Oh man, counting this one?
Yeah. So which movie? So this is the last one in the Ju-on.
I actually think there's only three counting this one. I think that's like there's more American than Japanese Ju-ons.
This is the ninth Japanese.
What?
No.
For The Grudge, really? There's been nine of them?
Ju-on the Curse, Ju-on the Curse 2, Ju-on the Grudge, Ju-on the Grudge 2, Ju-on White Ghost, Ju-on Black Ghost, Ju-on Beginning of the End, Ju-on the Final Curse. Just like American movies, the final one is never the final one. And then Sadako vs. Kayako.
Oh, wow. So, I've only seen two of them. I thought there were more.
There was a Netflix Ju-on Origins television show.
Oh, yes.
I did not.
I need to watch that. I may watch that this week.
And there was a video game that came out in 2009. So
I bet that's a lot of fun to play.
I bet it was
great. Hell do you do in that game?
All right, the Ring franchise. How many American Ring movies have there been?
They only made, they made two based on the original Ringu and Ringu 2. They never did Ring Zero. And then they did Rings, which is the internet one. Mm-hmm. And I believe that's it, unless you're going to count that Scary Movie 3 cameo.
Absolutely not. There is three, correct. How many Japanese Ring movies have there been?
There's a lot. I know there's Ring Zero, there's Ring Two. I think there's a Ring Three. There's probably like that's where at four. I'm gonna guess six, but I've only seen four.
So I'm gonna count. There was a TV movie for the Ring that started it. I can either count that or not count that. Either way, you're wrong, so it's fine. So there was Ring. Kanzenban, that was the TV movie. There's Ring. There was Rasen, which is the sequel to Ring.
This is fun. I am enjoying you pronouncing
Ring 2, these. Ring 2, The Ring Virus, Ring Zero Birthday, Ring Zero. I knew that's the one I knew. Sadako 3D, Sadako 3D 2.
Oh, I forgot about the Sadako 3D movies.
Sadako vs. Kayako and Sadako in 2019. So... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This was the 9th and 10.
Yeah, it's. Woo. I mean, I knew it was huge, but wow.
Yeah. Had two video games. That one, and if you want to go back and play The Ring: Terror's Realm on your Dreamcast. You totally can. So there you go. So there's a lot of films. In these series. I only knew of like three Ring movies from Japan. 0, 1, and 2. I had no idea. And in Ju-on, I knew there was a bunch, but not... I knew that... I thought there was about five. And I was absolutely...
What's Ju-on?
Ju-on is The Grudge.
Juon's the Grudge. It's the, yeah.
That's just the Japanese title for it.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
It's the Grudge series, but it's Juon the Grudge is like the
That's
movie.
That's weird.
Juon the Grudge 2, and then Juon, White Ghost, Black Ghost. Yeah, there's all kinds of stuff. So the movie came out, like I said, 2016. It was directed by Koji Tsurashi. That person's first major movie was Noroi, which I believe is on Shudder.
Oh yeah, Noroi the Curse.
It's real good.
Yeah. Noroi is incredible.
It's a really good found footage movie. One of the top tier found footage movies that's probably ever been made.
Yeah, that's also on the list of movies good. I wanted to watch for this podcast, but I want to slowly introduce the J horror.
I'm retiring. Yeah, it's all good. Watch it if you want.
That movie is freaking good. That one is great. Highly recommend that. Then you got some weird stuff. There's a slit mouthed woman, which apparently is an urban legend.
Yeah, that's a very famous urban legend. Yep.
Yeah. But there's
they mention it in this movie, actually, I think, too.
They do. Yeah. There's grotesque, occult, Teke Teke 2, same year. You got a movie just called Cult. I'm assuming Mitch is very down for that. There's like almost no reviews on any of these. A Record of Sweet Murderer. That's right. Not Sweet Murder. Sweet Murderer. You got Sadako versus Kayako. And then the next three movies after that are Impossibility Defense, Hell Girl, and A Beast in Love. So seems to be on the downslope. In terms of the actresses in this, I did not know any of them. So is there even a point of me mispronouncing all of the Japanese names for the movies?
Outside of upsetting potential listeners in Japan, no, not really.
I know. We have a couple of Japan listeners. I will say this. The main actress in this movie started as a model.
Which main actress? Depends on what story you're more interested in.
Mizuki Yamamoto.
So that wasn't so bad. You did it. That was good. I think that was fine.
Oh, yeah. No, but the names are not too bad. The titles, ooh boy. But she was in one that I can definitely pronounce called The Lunchtime Detective.
Aww, that sounds cute.
Which sounded like something that Lisa would like. So there you go.
Yeah.
Her next film is called Ghost Hunt. Is it a follow-up to this movie? Probably not, because she is murdered. Actors, actresses.
Wait, you're not going to give a shout-out to like the one dude that we've seen in a movie?
I was gonna get to it, but you can go ahead. Where's your what shout out?
He's excited about this one. He's like, I know that guy.
Masanobu Ando. Yeah, it's the battle royale.
It's
the crazy battle royale guy. Masanobu. The
crazy battle. Yes.
And he basically plays almost the same character.
Yeah. Imagine if that guy was like a medium.
Right.
Imagine if that guy survived and became a medium. Same character. Yeah. So there's that guy. That's it. The only thing that I gotta say is that in this movie, they really upped the ante on these curses, because in the other movies, the curses are taking longer. And this movie, it's like hyperspeed. Like, you got 2 days, you got 48 hours.
Yeah, I don't remember.
You don't get the week that you had before. No, it is 2 days, and that is it. So they really compress the timelines, these curses. Maybe there's like a curse half-life or something. It's like degrading back down to zero. I don't know what's happening.
I think it's just that there's not enough people. I mean, at this point, there's not enough people watching VHS tapes. She's like, look, can't wait a week. You know, I got to give them like a couple days.
That's fair.
People already figured out the secret, which apparently doesn't work in this movie.
Yeah, that was amazing.
Yeah.
You really believe that rumor? So that means the other movies weren't canon?
That means they all died. The end. That means what happy ending you thought may have existed did not.
Nope.
But yeah, so this movie, it gets, yeah, there's, and I haven't seen Rings, which is, you said, the internet one.
Yeah, it is. Garbage.
It seemed bad.
I mean, this one also has an internet spin to it.
Yeah, there's a little bit of an internet thing. This one was almost predominant. I mean, it was a lot of kind of that part of the thread, professor, and there. It part of that almost you could say what kind of got lifted. I don't know when the time it came out, but yeah.
Yeah, and so yeah, it's that. And then I do have to do the caveat. One of my first dates ever, my first date with someone I was with college was to The Ring 2. That was my first date.
Look,
with this person.
If you're serious serious about someone, you introduce them to The Ring early on, and if they stay, it was meant to be. It's like when if you love something, let it go. If you love something, make it watch The Ring, and if it stays
if you like it, then you should have put The Ring on it.
Lisa,
you should have been flattered. You should have been flattered.
Yeah.
There you go.
That's right. I love it.
No Mitch better time for my early. Retirement.
Mitch was committed so early. Anyway.
For those of you that are going to miss me, starting a spinoff podcast, okay, nothing but happy stuff. Join me there.
What's the name of the podcast?
Lisa's Happy Fun Time.
Lisa's Happy Fun Time. All right.
Mm-hmm. Texas Happy Time Podcast.
Yeah.
Texas Podcast Happy Time.
Mm-hmm. What percentage of that podcast is Harry Potter based?
Don't worry about it. Do we potentially go into a deep dive of the whole series? Maybe. Okay.
Okay. Wow.
Did we do it in July? Because that's when Harry was born? Maybe.
Oh.
Okay.
Hey, it took you 3 months or like 2.5 years to do theme months. She's already got him cranked and ready to go.
Done.
That's the whole theme of the whole show. You're going to release one episode per day in July and then take the rest of the year off.
Yeah.
That actually would be awesome.
Yeah.
I might switch over to Lisa's.
All right. So, sure. We'll just do, it'll be Mitch's J horror show after that, you know, where I'll just pretend to know what I'm talking about with Japanese stuff. So, all right. So look, I've been dying. I've been waiting. What did y'all think?
Oh my God. Nathan, Lisa, go first.
Nathan, what are you like? Parent?
I got to get serious now.
Nathaniel.
Serious. Really serious. Look, I liked it. I'm gonna go on a limb and say this is the best movie of the month.
You can't come on my new podcast.
I'm gonna go the opposite direction, and the reason for that is that this is pretty much not a versus movie, and I like that better. So what I've learned is I don't like versus movies very much because it always devolves into just like some half-brained plot to get these things together because people want to see them fight. I prefer a story, and this film is essentially a Ring movie with like
and a grudge movie
kinda, with the grudge kind of coming in, but it's mainly a Ring. The main people you're with most of the time is Ring based.
Mm-hmm.
But then the grudge comes in and then it merges the stories in a more organic way. So I liked that the story was better. So I'm not the typical versus person. Everyone's going to hate me. People were like, you didn't like Freddy versus Jason. It's like,
because a lot of times in the versus movie, you don't quite see how these two polar opposite things are going to match up. Right. Like Freddy versus Jason, they kill in totally different ways. These two, you know, Godzilla versus, I don't know. Yeah. It's
the most cohesive story of the movies.
It was.
For sure. I don't think it's even close.
It was a good story because I was like, how are they going to get these two together? And how they got them together made sense, was logical. Yeah. Could it have been a hair shorter? And I know it's not even that long of a movie, but there's a couple of parts where I would have shortened the deaths just a hair because I wanted, and I'll explain more, but I wanted a hair more of the end here and there.
Yes.
I felt like the end was just rushed.
It was a little abrupt.
So,
or very abrupt, actually, is what I'm doing.
I will never watch it again. Never. But I agree that the story, how they put them together makes sense.
I mean, the kills in this movie are better than anything in Alien vs. Predator.
Are they?
Yeah, the actual kills are like, oh man, when they happen, you're like, holy
they're really
shit.
Bad. They're they are really, really, rough. Really bad.
I mean, in you know, Godzilla versus Kong, it's just apparently 10 million people died. No one cares, so that's fine. And then
why are you going out to dinner when you know these things are there? Okay, sorry, that's my rant over.
I think there's something, you know, I think why Sadako and why they both work so well is that, you know, they have that same vibe that Jason has, that relentless, it's never going to stop coming for you. But I think because they're ghosts, it doesn't seem as stupid. Like, it's like, don't hide in the barn. He'll find you. Right. Like, there's always kind of something where you're yelling. I'm like, don't be stupid. In this movie, it never feels like any of the people getting killed are being stupid outside of watching the tape. Like, in terms of them trying to avoid getting killed, that slow, like, movement.
You
know what I mean?
Seriously?
What?
Every single person in this movie is stupid. What do you mean? Let's go in this haunted house.
What haunted house are they going to?
The Grudge's house.
Oh, no. I was talking about the ring more so than the Grudge.
Oh,
but
well,
yeah.
Everyone who died at the Grudge's hand was...
Yeah.
Except for the parents coming to save their daughter.
Yes, the parents really got sad. Got done dirty.
Yeah.
Oh, and does the kid die? No. Do the kids die in this? It doesn't matter.
Cut,
it doesn't matter if you're
Nate. The grunt.
Cut. Hold on. Now, cut to Mitch frantically Googling 30 seconds before it happens to give me a heads up. These kids are not gonna make it.
Because
I could remember if the
multiple kids.
Well, I could remember if the bullied kid also ate it or just the bullies.
Oh, the bully kid. The bully kid got rocked.
So, Nate, I mean, The Grudge has to be like a top Nathan movie because it has child endangerment, animal death, and gruesome kills and weird noises that you can impersonate. I gotta figure it's in the pantheon.
I like Jew on the Grudge quite a bit.
Yeah,
I like that. That was.
Are you more? Let's get on the phone. Are you more of a Grudge or a Ring fan?
I think in the Japanese movies,
it doesn't matter.
I like Jew on better from the top echelon. Jew on I like better than the Ring. However, I will say that just because those movies are better doesn't mean the other person's better. I mean, Sadako is essentially the Godzilla, and Kayako is maybe King Kong.
That's fair. Lisa,
in terms of the overall power.
What about you?
Don't even ask me.
You know, that's fine. Yeah, I mean, I'm certainly more of a Ring person.
Yes. Oh, really? Wow, that was shocking.
Right.
That was
well, I yeah.
Wow.
Surprise.
If you haven't been paying attention.
Yeah. This, I mean, yeah. I'm just so happy I watched this movie.
I'm waiting for your treatise on the Ring. Whenever we get to that episode,
that's gonna be like turn off my mic. That's gonna be a 3-hour episode of me going into all the symbolism and everything. Oh man,
maybe that's a drinking episode, but just for me. Hold on a second.
You got one.
There you go.
There we go.
Ring movie out of me, and it was this one. So sorry, you picked which one, and it was this one.
You tried to give her the ring and she rejected it.
I mean, let's talk about this movie. So I think you're right, Nate. I mean, this is very much, I mean, but you are right. It's very much the two individual movies, and then they merged kind of at the end because it all has the same beats of a Ring movie. All has the same beats of a Grudge movie. And I do think that's pretty effective.
The Ring movie is essentially urban legend.
Yeah,
it's exactly the same thing. It's urban legend. Replace Robert Englund with this other professor guy, and then you got some of the students, and yeah, that's it. It's urban legend.
Yeah, what I think worked for me a lot in this movie is that, and what made it different is that it started off basically like that movie, but let's just jump in like the best, like really the, oh, sorry. The best like scene in the entire movie, which is the exorcism that happens.
Oh my God.
Because that's when the movie changes from just a general like creepy girl crawling out of a TV to, oh shit, we are like,
had all the kids died by then?
So all the kids are dead by this point.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. I'm like, that was something.
Oh, well, you want to talk about the kid death? Of course you do. Let's just talk about the kid death first.
I'm just saying that was like, oh man, you're gonna kill off like four.
Which
kids
is a shame because you know that kid, the kid being bullied, definitely had like a future as a baseball pitcher because he was just nailing that one kid with rocks. Like
that kid threw a rock right at that kid's face
twice,
on point, both times. That was impressive. Yeah, that guy could have been thrown out. He could have been pitching after, you know, Sadako threw out the first pitch. He could have been actually pitching professionally. That kid had a future. He died massively. And yeah, I mean, a bunch of kids got murdered. Just right. I mean, they're like, look, everything is game here. Yeah. I mean, the one friend, you know, watches the tape and, you know, tries killing herself. After putting the video on the internet, which is shady.
She's like, if I'm going down, y'all are all going with me.
Look, all right, Lisa, all right. I was having this conversation with my wife. So she watched part of this and she didn't hate it. So that was surprising. If you are, you're a college student, right? You're a female college student and you have watched the cursed video and you only have 2 days instead of 7, 2 days to have someone else watch it or else you die. I mean, how fast could you get a guy in your room to watch this movie? Like, would you do that? Would you pass it on to somebody, let them know you have 2 days to show this to somebody else?
No, like, no worries, because I never watched it in the first place.
But if you did on accident, which is what happened in this movie, it was definitely an accident.
She could have looked down. Her friend looked down. It was not an accident. Come on, man. Yeah. You got to protect yourself.
Also, the looking down.
You just
down
sat through
real...
an entire lecture about this stuff.
This is why I never, like, Mitch is like, you got to watch this YouTube video. This thing's hilarious. I'm like, do I, though?
Do I? I'm either going to get Rickrolled or I'm going to get Cytocode. So what do you want from me?
Rick roll v Sadako. Yeah, I don't know. Or Sadako. I don't know, but I thought she could just be like, look, get a random guy in your.
But they said that doesn't work.
Like, hey.
Remember? They said that was just bullshit.
Yeah, in this movie they said
that's
right.
Yeah, you really believe that would work?
Yeah, they retcon like everything to destroy the rules
right. Shit, I forgot about that.
Yeah, okay. Good job.
Never mind. And then that would have killed more people. So, all right, that would have sucked. Never mind. Anyway, she tries to kill herself. She can't even kill herself
without she's interfering with the curse.
Absolutely murdered.
That was really bad too.
That was bad. There was.
There's
good
not a single death.
This.
There's not a single death in this entire movie that isn't bad. No. They are all really
that exorcism.
By bad, you mean good. Like
that exorcism scene where the one priestess is just slapping everybody and then she just gets straight like ganked. Like, I don't know how else to describe it.
So the one lady breaks the one lady's like neck, right? Like snaps
the disciple or whatever. Yeah.
Snaps her own neck.
Like all the way back.
All the way back.
Yeah.
It kind of reminded me of like Hereditary. It's like you just murder yourself like so hard. Like, man. And then there is the, you know, we were talking about way back when we did the Hand That Rocks the Cradle episode, where it's like, this is one of the best punch. This is one of like the most like thunky punches ever, right? Mm-hmm. Where she gets punched right in the face. And it was like, damn, that was a fucking punch. This movie features that equivalent times a million headbutt wise.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know. What happened to this, to that guy's face? What happened to the professor's face? What happened? It was like stretched.
Yeah, it just straight exploded.
A cartoonish degree, but it didn't explode. It was just like stretched. Like, did all the bones shatter, but like the skin stayed connected? Because that, I can't even describe it. It was horrifying. It was very good. I don't know. I can't even describe it. It was crazy. Lisa, what did you think about that whole scene?
All of it was awful. And I felt this is going to sound weird. I felt a hair bad for him because he was so desperate to see Sadako and he never did. He was like, if I just see her, then I can die happy, which is really freaking weird. But
that was weird.
He just randomly dies. It's like, all right, well, that guy's gone.
I'm never going to get tenure. They're never going to give it to me. I gotta see Sadako. That's all I got. I don't know. That scene was fucking brutal.
Yeah.
It kind of reminded me of kind of the wailing in a way of the whole mm-hmm. thing, the whole shaman kind of deal, right? The shaman is slapping the shit out of people. That seems like it's a common, I don't know, common East Asian thing. I have no clue. And yeah, I mean, that was rough. So the curse kind of ended for the one girl then, right?
What?
No.
No?
No, it didn't. They were trying to end the curse.
Nate,
right?
Did you watch this movie?
Yes, sorry. That's not what I meant. I meant they were trying to end the curse for her.
Yes.
Right.
And then what? Four people die, right?
Right.
Yes.
So then you're just like, okay, well, I went to like the B-level shaman, right, to get rid of this curse. And then she was like, I'll watch it again and you give it to me. But clearly that didn't work, right? So I was looking too far into that plot point. Then they bring up Battle Royale, like
they already had like guy. I don't know. They already had like a stack of cash, like they had a whole bag ready for him.
This guy,
like I've already called him up. Just FYI, I was like, well, why didn't you just wait till he got there?
This guy is like a medium with like telekinesis. Like this guy has like for real powers just randomly in the world.
There's a lot. Yeah.
That was surprising. Although if ghosts are real and curses are real, why can't?
I'll say this in the Japanese Ring movies, there's a lot more stuff around ESP and telekinesis and all that. And that's part of that's a major point in several of the sequels. And part of why she like talks to horses and all that kind of stuff.
But this guy is like commanding it. Like this is like the David Copperfield.
Yeah. That's what I mean. It's not surprising from that perspective. Yeah.
And then he's got a blind kid sidekick who's very in tune with the spirits.
His associate.
Yeah. Yes, his associate. Yeah. And so then they bring them in after everyone gets murdered. Friend's dead. And then the four people die first, then the friend dies.
Yeah.
Then you bring in this person. This guy's cool as shit. Until he gets absolutely murdered.
Yeah.
And everyone dies. I mean, you know, there's a young girl in high school. She's living there. She sees the ghost of the I think it was the rock kid, right? The ghost of the rock kid.
Yeah.
She
sees him a couple times before he dies.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then he like lures her in there and then her parents come to save her and they die.
Her parents come and her this was unintentionally hilarious and is probably like a negative point or 2 points for me. What happened to the mom's leg? Why did her leg all of a sudden go away?
Yeah, we were confused by that too.
All of a sudden, so like, you know, Kaiko's just ganking people and that's kind of the standard move. Toshio is creeping them out from behind, standard move. But then all of a sudden, you know, I think the dad dies and the mom is like, you know, classic horror thing, like falling down, whatever. And they are not running out the door. I mean, I was yelling at them through my screen, run out the door. And they were not doing it. They were just horrified. Then all of a sudden, the mom's legs are gone. What?
Yeah, it was weird.
I didn't know that was part of the repertoire of Kayako. It was just dissolving legs somehow.
You ain't got no legs.
Wow. So that was really weird and I did not like that and it made no sense. So then the high school girl escapes, but she's obviously cursed by the house. So you got curse v curse and Battle Royale guy gets them together and it kind of makes sense. Like we'll just cancel each other out, but no. What did you guys think about this end plan? So the guy, Battle Royale guy, plans out how to, you know, cancel these things out. I mean, what did you think of this plan just in general? Did you think
fine.
It was gonna work?
I mean, I had no issue with the plan. I think everything inside the house was fine. Like, once they finally fought each other, because I was like, how are these are, one crawls on the floor and the other uses, I don't know. It was fine. Like, grabbing the ghost kid through the TV and then using her hair and then exploding her, but then she came back. Like, that was all fine. Because I was like, I don't know how they're going to get these two to fight, but they did an okay job.
But to be fair,
everything after that outside was ridiculous.
Yes. Yeah. The fight was like 45 seconds.
Yeah. So the fight inside, I was like, this is fine. But then the whole well thing and sacrificing somebody, which, oh my God, he comes back so casually. He's like, sorry, guys, one of you is going to have to die. Oh, thanks, man.
By the way, forgot to mention that as part of the plan. Jeez. One of you guys got that.
So, go ahead.
The college girl was way too ready to die. Way too ready. She saw her friend die.
I think she felt like it was all her fault to begin with.
Sure. But she's like 21 and she's like so willing to die for like some random person she's never met. That was weird. But yeah, the fight, I want to talk about the fight because it barely happens. The fight is maybe a minute.
Yeah. Maximum. I mean, but yes. I agree. Yeah. However, what else are you going to do? I mean, they did their signature moves, right?
That's what I'm saying. And I think that's why the other movies go the other way. They just go, we're going to get the fight in and we'll figure it out the rest of the way. This movie, they had a good plot, I think, that tied in both things. But then when you actually got them together, they were like, what can we even?
Yeah.
One person is crawling going, and the other one has got like a weird, you know, curse eyeball. And really long hair.
Yeah.
And like, that's it. You have nothing to work with. So it was the reverse problem from the other movies. Mitch, what do you think about the fight? Did it live up? I mean, like, it's ring versus grudge, right? So what do you think about the actual versus component here?
I mean, yeah, it's hard to have imagined it being like, you know, you walk into Freddy versus Jason and you have expectations, right? You expect them to actually fight. You expect there to be a lot, and it delivered in that regard. When they did finally meet up, this same kind of thing. I think Lisa was pretty spot on. I mean, what do you expect, right? I think you do have a good match. They're just slower moving until the end, which then kind of throws off. Why were y'all so slow moving? If y'all could, like, I mean, look, that end scene, they just straight hustle. Like, they just fly. And I mean, a lot
gets thrown out the window because she leaves the house. Grudge leaves the house. They're flying through the air. It's like, all right, we're just going to throw everything out. Fine.
Yeah. I mean, that's probably the only real major fault I have with this movie is that it just throws too much away of canon.
Yeah.
To try to just make something more visually interesting and to try to like it almost like retconning things because it's like, oh yeah, you can break the curse by showing it to people. Well, I guess there's no need to have her fight Kayako then, because it seems like this curse is pretty easy to get bypass. You know, there's stuff like that. Yeah, but the actual fight itself, like the fight inside the house with the hair grabbing, the explode, all the stuff was, I thought, well, like it matched what it was. Yeah. I think they were smart to keep it inside the house in those close quarters with the girls right there instead of having some big expansive like warehouse or something, right? Like
exactly.
It made it feel very tight. I think there could have been a little bit more even where it was like they were trapped in like, it felt more, they were saying, it felt like they were just fighting in a hallway. Like if they had been in the same room with the girls,
they were literally in a hallway.
Yeah. I think putting them a little bit more in the room would have been a little bit more interesting, but I liked it. I thought the fight was interesting. Again, I think, yeah. I agree. I kind of agree with a lot of what both of y'all said because I do think
now it gave the ending.
This ending.
The ending, though. Whoa, the ending is.
Okay,
is
so here's. Let me go back to my original
controversial.
Point. Yeah. Here is where I think the ending would have been fine if they had let it breathe for a few more seconds. It all moves very, very, very fast and then it's just over. So she sacrifices herself in the well. Sadako and Kayako do some smash explosion bang thing that kills the medium, which I still don't understand that part, but whatever.
It does just kill. It splits him the fucking half.
That made no sense to me, but he has to die, so okay. So they go in the well. The young associate says, cover the well, cover the well. It's over, it's over. And not 2 seconds later, they come back out. I'm like, if you had covered the well and there had been some time to breathe and they had been like, oh my God, I can't believe we did it. Oh my God. Like, it just taken a second. And then they were like, oh no. But it's like, boom, 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 over. It's like they ran out of, they were like, this has to only be this certain amount of minutes and we're running out of time. Just go. So that's the only thing I think, if they had given it like 10 more, because it happens in every movie. Every single Freddy, every single Jason, they're like, everything's okay. Or is it? But they give it a second before they reveal, yeah, of course they're not dead, you know?
Yeah. The ending, I think you're right. I think it's rushed. For me, how I would have done it is I would have had the one girl, doesn't matter which one, I guess the grudge, maybe the grudge girl, because she's lost her parents. Sure. She should have been the one in the well. And I think what should have happened is, as they were fighting in the house, Kayako comes out of the house as the winner and starts crawl. Like, you see her in the well just like hiding. And then you see Kayako start crawl. You know, you hear the noise, see her crawl over the top and just start like creepy crawling all the way down along the sides, you know, spider like or whatever. And then as she, you know, then they close it up. Right. And seal her in. They're like, great, we're going to seal her in the well. And then she's stuck. And Sadako is also dead now, I guess. Anyway, I think inside the ring, or inside the well.
Where are you going with follow, this?
I'm just saying, apart. What I'm saying is they should have only trapped, when they trapped them, to your point, they should have trapped just a single entity, like Kayako, in the well. And been like, okay, great. We're done. Sadako's been destroyed and Kayako's trapped in the well. Because then when it pops up, I think the intent is that the reason why it bust out of the top was because this was a more powerful entity because they merged and joined. Mm. And
or
you don't get that.
It just fucking like paper thin.
Well, but that's
covering the well could also have been a factor.
Well, that's the problem, right?
Terrible.
Because they rushed so fast, it makes it look real shitty. Like, this was a real dumb fucking plan. Like, it makes the ending seem so worse.
They covered it with like paper, or like maybe canvas level. There's little wooden posts and they just like slide like the daintiest rope over like two or three posts. That was it for Sadako and Kayako, these two powerful curses that have killed innumerable amount
well,
of people.
Well, and so and again,
that was the plan. Not even don't even put a rock on top. Nothing.
Well, just let so it go, let's apparently. But let's be fair. I mean, I think there's a little bit of a cultural thing here. I mean, I think it was, it had the papers on it, so I think it was supposed to be, it had been blessed and had, like, you know, other things there. I think, yes, it looked, in execution, looked real fucking stupid. Terrible. But I think had they done something where, again, I think, to Lee's point, slow it down, maybe demonstrate that it could have stopped one of them, and the fact that they merged is why it was able to bust out, because it was so powerful. That would have made it sound a lot cooler.
But the thing they merged into is, like, this weird gob of like what is kind of like a rejected version of like the dogs from The Thing.
Yeah.
Like, it was like this weird, I don't know why two very like, you know, two long haired skinny ghosts turn into like some like huge blob when they're like mashed together. I'm not sure why that happens.
So, okay. But, I think what you're supposed to take from the ending is, when they got all smashed to the bits, their ectoplasm, if we want to go all Ghostbusters.
Their cursed DNA got merged,
and they were in that weird form. I think they effectively possess the girl that's in the well. And so she becomes the body that now has both the spirits. And that's the why.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. So I don't think they just, it was weird. there's a lot that happens real quick that you've got.
So the architect of this, the battle royale medium guy, is like, get behind me. I mean, he gets cut in half. So brutally. Yeah. He just gets cut in half from the initial. What is the combined nickname? What is the Bennifer combined nickname for these people? What do we got?
Sayako.
Sadako.
Sadako?
Yeah.
Like a Sudoku? Sadako. So Sadako, Sadako, Sadako cuts that guy in half. And then you're like, oh, is another girl going to die? The blind girl who's very sensitive to spirits. Oh, the answer is a hard yes. Apparently Kayako and Toshio are like, they're two entirely separate entities.
Mm-hmm.
Like they're not part of the same curse. I thought they'd be part of the same. I thought it was like a package deal.
They're part of the same curse.
But he didn't morph in.
Well, no, because he didn't like attack.
He stayed in the house.
Yeah.
But I'm saying like, you know, I thought it was like a package deal where it's like,
they're tied to the same location, but they're not like they're two separate entities, but the curse is tied to the location.
So the son has become, he's like, he's got like bar mitzvah. Like he's like, I'm my own.
I guess I feel for the poor cat that's like trapped in the boy's body.
Yeah, that's not great. Yeah. And then so yeah, go through the ending here. So the guy gets cut in half. Toshio grabs the girl, and then the person who everyone sacrificed to save, what happens with?
You talking to me?
No, well, either of you.
We
already just talked about the whole ending. They emerge as
What do you think about, so like, you know, there's one, the girl is left, right, from the grudge thing, and then the ending happens. What do you think? Like, was it fair? Was it terrible? What do you think?
It was fine. It was expected. The ending of them coming back out of the wall is not shocking. It happens in every single horror movie. The main villain's never dead.
It was the Freddy versus Jason ending, except now they're one spirit.
Well, they merged though, and now they're even scarier and more powerful, I guess.
Yeah, and if you had watched after the end credits, Nate,
which I did not do,
you would have seen now if you watch the curse tape, it's the hybrid them.
Oh, yeah. Is it only one day now?
Probably.
Right. It got more efficient.
It got way more efficient.
Yeah.
Two for the price of one.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So now I want to hear ratings.
Well, Lisa's calling it. She's ready. Let's get into the final cut.
I'm gonna be as abrupt as this ending was.
Final cut.
True story. Yeah, very abrupt.
Okay, let Nate go first because I have. Because this is why you're definitely in between me and Mitch. There's no way you're not. So you set the bar, and then we'll see what happens.
You know, the ending. If the ending would have been better, this could have been like a really like this could have been good. Like upper medium good. Now, you know, with the ending being great, I mean, I liked the movie basically until the ending. It got a little slower in parts, but you know, you got to do some investigation. It only takes place over the course of 2 days, so it tightens it up. It could have been a little shorter. I think of like 5-10 minutes shorter, Lisa, would have been perfect, like right at 90 minutes.
Yeah,
like right there, maybe a little below would have probably been perfect in terms of like the pacing. But it was really good, you know. I don't know, compared to Freddy vs. Jason and Alien vs. Predator and Godzilla vs. Kong, I like this one probably the best. I'm gonna give it a 6 out of 10 headbutts.
All right.
I liked it. This is the same run. The Noroi the Curse guy has got me with two movies. Everything else that I listed out sounds terrible from this guy, but he's got two good ones. That's all you need. So 6 out of 10 headbutts for me.
All right, Lisa, what about you?
It was okay. The story, I agree with Nate. The lead up and getting them together made sense, which really helped the movie overall, because if it had not made sense, it would have been really hard to watch. The ending, like we talked about, I don't know. I mean, it was fine. Y'all are probably going to be absolutely shocked. I'll probably give it a 5 out of 10.
Right in the middle.
It was fine.
I'm shocked. That's higher than what I would have guessed.
I don't like those things, but they did a good job. So
the kills were so much better than they had any right to. All the kills were good.
Yeah.
I haven't seen Ju-on the white ghost, Ju-on the black ghost, Ju-on the beginning of the end, you on the final curse. But my assumption is that hopefully they that those were kind of like the those were like the Jason goes to Manhattan type deals. And then we got like a, you know, like a Jason reboot, like a little bit better kind of rebooted kind of version. You know, I think it's like this. I think I read in the information I was looking at, it's like this is like the seventh person to play Kayako or something. Like they just there's been so many movies, like they just have a million people. But I'm hoping, you know, like it seems like this one they kind of like they kind of got a more cohesive, hopefully better story. And one thing I didn't mention about this is that they teased it as an April Fool's thing in 2015. And everyone was like, oh, that's hilarious. And then like they generated so much buzz that like by the end of the year, they're like, oh no, but we're actually making this now. At least it's like, I wish it would have stayed April Fool's joke, but yeah, here we are. 5 out of 10, I guess not so bad. All right, Mitch, what is your ranking?
Okay. So first off, you said, Lisa, you thought I've seen it 3 times. Nate, you thought you had me at the under or the over?
I had you exactly at 3. I was picking 3.
Okay. So y'all both thought 3.
Yeah. How many? Mitch has seen it 9 times. Mitch has seen it 9 times. No. 9 out of 10.
No.
That would have been perfect.
This time, yeah, this time makes it the 4th.
Oh,
the nice. Prior to this, it was 3.
Wow. Okay. Sorry. 4 out of 10. Right.
Yeah. I mean, I love this movie. I think it's great. I obviously, yes. Love.
Where look. Does it fall in the pantheon of these? Do you like it more than Ring?
No. Okay, look, okay. The Ring is again as near a perfect horror movie as you can.
I'm talking about the Japanese one, the Ring. I'm talking about Ring.
I like Ringo too. It doesn't strike as hard because there's some cultural stuff that doesn't really resonate with me. Right, like seeing weird pictures of Buddhists, like in the thing. It's like that probably means something to somebody. Doesn't
what the fuck is this? This is
right. In Ringu, the video is shorter. In the American version, they extended the video to have
way longer.
Yeah. So, I mean, in this case, yeah, I like the movie. I think for me, it starts to fall off right around when the Battle Royale guy shows up because he's a little too, like, just. Hey, it's like the Fonz just walking in like, hey, we're going to just fucking have demons fight each other. Y'all ready to do this?
He hits the jukebox and all the demons.
He just grabs the bag of cash. And it's like, hey, y'all want to just have some demons fight?
I'm not going to lie. I like the guy quite
a bit. Yeah, I know.
Guy was awesome.
It's a terrible idea. Hey, here's an idea of how we could break your curse. Let's bring in a second curse. I mean, at no point does adding something to a disaster make it better. Like, hey, we're tornadoes tearing through. What if add fire? Like, it does not make it better.
Blood poisoning bad. Leeches bad. Leeches with blood poisoning maybe good. See, that's it's the leeches strategy. Classic move.
Right.
It did not work out.
That's where it falls because it comes in right after you just have this like. Massive, like, awesome scene with the exorcism, right? And then he just comes in and it's like, what is happening?
I loved it. I thought it was great.
The problem is, it's the kind of camp that would have been more appreciated in like Freddy versus Jason. This movie had not really been very campy at all up until he shows up.
This guy was so swaggy. He's all over
the place. And his smart aleck ass blind assistant.
I loved it. Kind of reminded me of the lady from Poltergeist.
A little bit, yes. I had that same vibe. Yeah, you're absolutely right.
Kind of reminded me of that. Loved it. I they were great.
Yeah. So I don't know. I like the movie. I mean, the fight scene I enjoy, and I do like the idea of them becoming this combined thing. I think that would have been more.
That's great. I wish it would have been just a little tighter.
I wish we had gotten to that sooner, and there had been more to it than just the final end of like, oh well, you're all hosed. Like,
agreed.
And maybe that is the right ending, but yeah, I would have liked to see more with that. So anyway, I think I'm going to give this, which I think is modest for me, a 7 out of 10 death rattles.
That's it, huh?
Nice. Okay.
Seven. Oh, you hated it.
This is a 5.1 on IMDb. 5.1. Wow.
Yeah.
So I agree with the masses.
Yeah, pretty much.
You're right there. Yeah, we're above. Yeah, I, man, if they could have tweaked a couple parts of this movie.
Oh, it could have very easily gone up. Easy. Yeah, it could have very easily gone up.
It was very good.
It's you know, I don't know if something happened and they were rushing at the end. If there's something with the editing, I don't. It just that whole ending thing just it
ran
just,
out of
the speed of it was just so much different.
Even
at the end, it's like the director's like, I mean, they must have had a time crunch because he's like, fuck it, y'all just run at each other at the well. No more crawling. Just get it. Like it was, you know, like it's like a real fight where like MMA in the corner. They're like, look, you got 1 minute left in the round. Just get it.
Let's get an interview with Koji Shirashi on the books, and we'll ask him.
There you go, Koji. You're always welcome on the show. All right. Well, look, that's gonna wrap it up for this week's episode. Nate, where can they find us?
And that'll wrap it up for Versus. That's right, our Versus April month, but we have some theme months coming up. Mitch was already yelling at me because we didn't start this until last year, but we have a lot of themes coming. So get ready for that. Episode 200 coming up next week. Wow. That is way too fast. Send us, I think we're going to do a mailbag, right, Mitch, for that one, I think.
Yep.
So send us your emails, send Lisa words of encouragement. Like when people retire, like you have like a thing, like what's an anti-retire? Like send her like the messages that's like, don't go, I need you.
Yeah.
Like a needy sort of person. It's like, I can't imagine the podcast without you.
How do I live without you?
Like this easily.
So send all of that, and yeah, we'll do a mailbag. We'll put it on social media, obviously. But yeah, episode 200. Do I tell them the movie, Mitch? Do I tell them the movie? Or do we wait? It sounds like you want to wait.
Let's wait.
So we'll wait, but it is a, and I'm not using this word lightly. This is a classic of horror cinema. That is not a classic. But it is. It's the cultiest of classics. So that'll be.
If you've when we announced, if you've never seen this movie, do yourself a favor. Make sure to watch it with friends. Get people. Get drinks. It is.
Oh, the drinks. The drinks will be flowing.
This is going to be a party episode.
The drinks will be flowing like milk.
We will be celebrating in this episode. I mean, 200 episodes is. Who would have thought we'd have made it this far? Who would have thought Lisa would still be here this long?
Lisa hasn't strangled Mitch yet, and that is cause for celebration. Get the streamers.
I've seen the movie they're talking about. I have seen half of it once.
Lisa.
Oh, you haven't even seen it? Oh, no.
No.
You weren't there.
Lisa walked out of the movie and
I went to bed.
She's like, I'm just going to bed. Good night.
The thing is, when we used to have parties, it's hard to tell, like, when, like, I feel like a lot of times Mitch and I were watching a movie with everyone else, and then all of a sudden it was just Mitch and I.
Yep.
Like, yes. That happened numerous times in numerous movies. Yeah. So it's hard to tell which of those times was which, but it's going to be a good one. So stay tuned for that. It'll be great.
Excellent. Lisa, thank you so much. I know you were having to confront some pretty deep-seated fears with watching The Ring and The Grudge for this
one.
Some
literal demons.
Yeah, some literal demons. So I appreciate everything you've done. You're not leaving the podcast, though, but I still appreciate everything.
We'll see.
Oh, goodness. All right, well, listen, from all of us here at Texas Podcast Massacre, thank you so much for tuning in, and just keep telling yourself it's only a movie. Good night. We'll be right back.